like an adrenaline junkie. You know, I love to push my body to its limits.
We're pretty much like ninjas out there, you know? We're doing flips and twists, and we have to find the ground after flipping over it twice. Six events to show, you know, what I'm capable of.
Paul Ruggieri III.
John Orozco, represent Team USA.
Gymnastics.
What makes a good all-arounder in gymnastics is being able to be flexible with all your events.
I really think it's the most difficult sport in the world that you could choose to do. You know, you have to be able to master so many different skills instead of just one or two, you know, in other sports.
Well, to be a good all-arounder, you have to have high difficulty, but you also have to have a great execution, which means you have to have good form on all your skills, pointed toes and everything, stick landings. And also, you have to be diverse. You know, you can't spend all your time on one event and expect to be a good all-arounder.
The majority of us train twice a day, so, you know, for example, on a Monday, we would wake up,
eat breakfast, probably some eggs and bananas, fruits,
go to the gym for about 2 hours in the morning, stretching and conditioning.
Do probably three events,
then we go have lunch,
in which I would probably spend my time doing my homework for my online college course.
Then we come back,
do the other three events, half routines and or routines.
Another 2.5, 3.5 hours.
Eat dinner, do a little more homework, and go to bed.
And then, you know, we come back in the next day and do it, you know, 6 times a week.
The first event is floor exercise, and you have to execute a routine of 10 skills.
In order to be good at floor, you have to be really quick twitch and strong in your legs.
You have 70 seconds to perform your whole routine.
It's just so amazing, you know, to have the feeling of pushing the limits of your body.
And then there's pommel horse, which is considered one of the hardest events for Team USA. And then there's steel rings, which is more about strength and holding your strength positions. And then there's vault, where you run as fast as you can and you try to execute the highest amount of difficulty over the vault.
The quicker you are, the more power you're gonna get, the higher you're gonna go, the more twists you can do, the more flips you can do, that kind of thing.
If you're like a specialist on rings, you would work pretty much your upper body and your core, and you wouldn't do that much for legs. But if you do a lot of floor and vault, you probably need strong legs.
You know, we do a lot of circuit stuff that keeps our power consistent. But we also do sprints to maintain our run, you know, because we're not a running sport, you know, so for us to sprint is kind of rare, but we do it, you know, to train for vault.
There's parallel bars, which is more of a support event and a swing event.
It definitely helps to be taller on this event and having good body awareness, you know, because you're going around and around. You got to be able to pay attention where you are, and your body has to know where you're going to be.
I would say that's personally my best event. And then there's high bar, which is probably one of the more exciting events.
There's a group called release, and so you have to do at least one release move in your high bar routine, and that's when you do these big flips and you catch the bar and you twist. It's just really impressive, you know, to the crowd and to the spectators of the sport. It really looks difficult when you're doing a flip and a twist and you have to catch the bar again without falling off and dying, you know? So obviously it's scary, you know? So in order to be able to let go, do a flip and to try to catch a metal bar without hitting your face or without hitting your body or peeling off and hurting your neck, you know, there's a lot of mental blocks that you have to get over. So we start when we're really young, doing drills and slowly easing our bodies into getting used to letting go and landing in a pit. Our sport is called artistic gymnastics, so, you know, the judges want to see you being really clean and making an art form out of your gymnastics. So you have to throw really big skills and you have to do them really clean so they look pleasing to the eye.
You're naturally going to have some weak spots, but all you have to do is make sure that you put more time into your weak spots to make everything equal.
It normally takes about 3 months, maybe 3.5 of full routine training to be at tip-top condition.
World Championships and the Olympic Games are a little different because you're already kind of in shape, so you just have to kind of maintain your abilities. There's not really a specific body part you have to be stronger with for all around because there's so many different types of gymnasts and different types of bodies. You know, it's very challenging, and you have 6 events and you have what seems like endless possibilities of skills to do. So I would say I love the challenge about it the most, and I also love the feeling of doing a great routine after years and years of training and finally being able to salute at the end and, you know, hear the crowd go crazy and know that your hard work paid off.